for weeks now. Not the entire time, so say for a couple of weeks now, I have not been able to trust her to take her meds on her own. So you know what that's meant for me? It's meant that even when I'm exhausted, I've had to force myself to stay awake. That's what it's meant for me. Even when I'm exhausted, I've had to force myself to get up in the morning, set an alarm, or just not really sleep, just not wear my earplugs, and kind of just, you know. Ever since that day, I woke up at 8:30, she hadn't taken her meds, okay? If I'd woken up later, she wouldn't have taken her meds. I'm basically keeping her above water, and she should have been gotten help weeks ago, okay? There was a day here or there, not recently, where I actually thought she was going to snap out of it. She can't snap out of it. Whatever's going on with her is deep and dark, and I'm not going to watch her like she wants to do. Clearly, she wants to kill herself slowly in front of me, okay? She wants to deteriorate, disintegrate, you know what I mean? I know she's dropped 15 pounds in a month. In a month. Okay? She dropped 8 pounds in 17 days. Tomorrow's D-Day. She either gets her ass to her psychiatrist or that's it. I will call 911, and if the police don't take her against her will, then it's on them if something happens to her, okay? How anyone could see her in the condition she's in now. I mean, how I've been seeing her lately, she belongs in a nursing home. I mean, it's sad. And then she gets these phone calls from her friend, the mentally ill friend, you know, the one that's been a friend for a long time, and, you know, I want to come down, when can I come down? This is bad. I don't even trust her psychiatrist to do anything. I really don't. I actually hope that, like I said in the other video, I hope that for whatever reason, she doesn't want to see him, that she says I can't move or something on the ride, and they call the police, and then that's it. She's automatically in the ER where she belongs. This is so bad. It is so bad. She's fucking skin and bones. And it's only gotten worse and worse since the 20th when I picked up the phone and called 911 and then they wouldn't take her against her will. Oh my God. That was over 2 weeks ago. And then last week was supposed to be D-Day. I couldn't even believe it. But she's not gonna get away with it this time. She's not gonna get away with it this time. They called to remind her, and it wasn't, you know, you have an appointment with Dr. So-and-so. Give us a call if you're not feeling well or can't make it or whatever. No, there was no that. It's you have an appointment with Dr. So-and-so. You better have arranged. I hope you arranged a ride. So they're being firm now too. But I won't even wait for it. If she doesn't get her ass on that ride tomorrow, which I'll be up and making sure she does, unless she just refuses to, and then I'm gonna call 911. I'm going to call 911. At this point, I'm hoping they'll fucking take her against her will, okay? Because this is getting dangerously ridiculous, absurd. obscenely, dangerously ridiculous, and I'm a fucking basket case in my every fucking waking moment, right? Just looking at her fills me, my heart just, it's awful. I've never seen her so skinny ever in my life. In my adult life, I've never seen my mother this skinny. And she did it to herself 100%. She got skinny before, and because that thing was going on with her physically, but this time it's solely because she's been starving herself. And she got even skinnier than before. Before, it was over the course of a few months. This is 15 pounds in a month, and I've watched it happen. I'm watching the skinniest jeans just hang off of her. It's fucking torture, and it is going to end one way or the other. I hope it doesn't end with something bad happening to her. I hope that she, by tomorrow, has the help that she's needed, and I've known she's needed, and I've told everybody she's needed for weeks.